Hello friends, on this occasion of World Elders Day, I'm going to narrate a story for you. My story starts in the year 1969 and here we go. Walking to college every day, my friend Geeta and me, we used to pass a newly set up dental clinic. The dentist of that clinic, standing in front, was watching us walking. After some days, that was very uncomfortable. We changed our route. Before that, we thought, are we really experiencing that? I wanted to check with Geeta. Geeta, do you feel that man is watching us? Oh, Kanil Alta. Even I feel like that. Geeta, ninnu nortta idano, nannu nortta idano. Yaarunno, bare lalta. Let him be watching. Hereafter, we will not come this way. We'll change another road. We could reach our college going through one more road. So we changed it and we were relieved. After a few days, on the newfound road, we spotted the same dentist in front of a canteen. We couldn't escape being watched. In a few days, our second year degree exam got over, and I went back to my village, Kattaya. But that was not the end. During this summer holidays, marriage proposal reached my father from the same dentist, asking for my hand. My appa, dodappa, anna, all started inquiring relatives and friends to find out details about the boy. Then one day, my appa and avva came to me. Magale, ammaya, il kelu. One dentist wants to marry you. He has already seen you. But appa, as you know, I don't want to marry a doctor. I know, ammaya. He is only a dentist. As though dentist is not a doctor. Appa, isn't it too early for me to get married? I'm only 17 years. I haven't even completed my graduation. ಅವ ನೀನಾದ್ರೂ ಹೇಳುವ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಕೇಳು ಮಗಳೇ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಎ ಗುಡ್ ಪ್ರಪೋಸಲ್ ವಿ ವಿಲ್ ನಾಟ್ ಗೆಟ್ ಇಟ್ ವೆನ್ ಎವರ್ ವಿ ವಾಂಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಐ ಪ್ರಾಮಿಸ್ ಯು ಯು ವಿಲ್ ಫಿನಿಶ್ ಯುವರ್ ಗ್ರಾಜ್ಯುಯೇಷನ್ ಈವನ್ ಆಫ್ಟರ್ ಯುವರ್ ವೆಡ್ಡಿಂಗ್ ಮೈ ಪೇರೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಮೀ ವಂಡರ್ಡ್ ಹೌ ಓಲ್ಡ್ ದ ಬಾಯ್ ಮಸ್ಟ್ ಬಿ ದೋಸ್ ಡೇಸ್ ನೋಬಡಿ ಆಸ್ಕ್ ದ ಬಾಯ್ಸ್ ಏಜ್ ಸೋ ವಿ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲೇಟೆಡ್ ರಫ್ಲಿ First standard by 5-6 years, 16 years SSLC, 17 years PUC, after that 4 years dentistry, 1 year house surgency. That came to 22 years. That is his first appointment. He is here in Hassan for 1 year. So together it is 23 years. Even if we add 2 years here and there, he must be around 25. This was our calculation. Appa added, 7-8 years difference is okay, magale. Yochne madu. Say yes. Avungu nangu ishta agide. In 3 weeks, I was married and sent off to my in-laws. Summer holidays. Oh, we came back to Hassan. He started his work. I went back to college. New life started. All good, all well. Slowly, but very frequently, I started feeling he is very matured. He behaves old and bossy. At the same time, he felt I'm very mature. Maybe 5-6 months later, after our wedding, one day, just like that, We both discussed about our age. I was 18, but he was 32. Both were shocked. Oh my God, what? 14 years of age difference. That was something I never wanted to happen. I felt very bad for that. I felt very bad for not insisting my father to find out about his age before wedding. Mentally, I had to jump from 18 years to 32 years. I never had my 20s in my life. He had crossed his gallivanting age. I had just started bunking college and going out with friends. Always I had to think at least 10 years older than my age to match with his thoughts. For many years, decision making was almost one-way process. Life was a challenge till we figured out some strong silver lines in our relationship. He was a big security for me and my children. Whenever we encountered tough situations, I was always there for him. Maintaining the house all over, I barely left any household risk for him. Anyway, he was not ready to take it up also. With all possible adjustments, life went on. Life went on. We were blessed with two beautiful daughters. Whenever we had some clashes, our maturity level used to play a role. Each such time, I told myself, I will not get my daughters married to an old person. And yes, we got them married to an appropriate age grooms. Slowly came the health issues. I was just 50 and was all set to explore the world. But many times things went beyond our control. I couldn't enjoy my 50s. Instead, I had to take one more leap from 50s to 60s to take care of my husband. He passed away at the age of 72 and I was 58. But today, as I look back, life was not that bad at all. I have lived a full life. And today I know age and happiness does not go hand in hand, isn't it?
Experiences, my God, these people were amazing. I just didn't do anything. It was their story. They brought it up. And it was so amazing to see how we can connect in these 4-5 days. So we've become very close. That's what I can say, Lalita auntie and Nanda auntie. And I told them, thanks for bringing. I just gave one spark to them. And the story was ready the next day. And they were like narrating like prose. Here and there, I had to give them a little bit of some kind of techniques, that's all. But otherwise, oh, today I'm the proud person sitting here and watching them and jumping and clapping for them. I was so happy to see you both tell. And I hope all of them enjoyed too. A slice of life. I'm very happy and contented.